Welcome. Social Science as per 2024 syllabus, Part 2, Chapter 15, The Mughals and the Marathas, 6th Standard, Part 1. Rise and Fall of the Mughal Empire. Introduction to the chapter. Babur invaded India in 1956 and, after overthrowing the Delhi Sultanate, established the Mughal rule. See, Babur was from Kabul. It was a small city in Afghanistan, and he invaded India. He captured the major cities of this part, this purple part. This was ruled by Babur. Later, it was extended. This chapter, the reign of the Akbar and Aurangzeb have been described. Their administration and contributions to culture are also delineated. At the end, the causes for the decline of the empire are mentioned. The chapter further describes Shivaji's childhood and ideals and how he repulsed the Mughals and Adil Shahis of Vijapur by his spirit of courage and adventure and built an independent Maratha kingdom. It also describes the main features of his administrative system, his extraordinary personality. Competencies. Appreciating Akbar's liberal policies and achievements, understanding how Aurangzeb's narrow-minded policies led to riots in the country and ultimately to decline of the Mughal Empire. Third one, appreciating how the Mughal emperors enriched the fields of literature and the art. Fourth one, marking on the map historical places relating to the Mughal era. Fifth one, appreciating the life and adventures, character and achievements of Shivaji. Sixth one, marking on the map places associated with Shivaji. Can you identify this monument? This is a Taj Mahal, Agra. This is the world famous Taj Mahal. This architectural wonder is a marble. In marble is a great contribution of Mughals. The founder of the Mughal dynasty was Babur. He was ruling the small region in Afghanistan called Kabul. This was his capital city. This is India. From here, he invaded India and was waiting for an opportunity to attack India, which was rich and prosperous. Babur belonged to the Mongol race. The word Mughal came from Mongol. The rose was introduced to India by Babur. Taking advantage of the growing weakness of Delhi Sultans, Babur invaded Delhi and ended their reign. This was the Delhi Sultanate's empire at that time, and it was the Kabul, which is the capital city of Babur, and he invaded from here. Delhi Sultanate, he captured the Delhi Sultanate, and later he extended to the, even to the later. Later, Akbar extended to the even to the south part, but he could not stop at that core because the Rajputs and the Afghans resisted him strongly. Rajputs were ruling in this part, and Afghans also opposed him. That's why. But the brave warrior that he was, Babur, with his powerful weapons and forced the opposing armies to retreat. He captured the opposition from the Rajputs and the Afghans. Soon Babur conquered Delhi. It was assumed at that time who captured the Delhi will rule the India. This was there at that time. So he captured Delhi, Agra and the surrounding areas and established his kingdom. This was ruled by Babur, purple part. But he died soon. His son, Humayun, ascended the throne. Humayun managed to overpower his enemies in the beginning. He had to face defeat at the hands of Afghan chieftain Sher Shah Suri. Having lost his kingdom, he fled to Persia and stayed there for 15 years. He went back. This is the India. This is the Persian Empire. We call it Iran, right? Right now, from this Afghanistan, this all our countries are involved in this. This was the Persia Empire. He went back there. He left India. Because of the Sher Shah Suri at that time, and he stayed there 15 years. When the Afghan rule in India weakened, Humayun invaded India and conquered Delhi. Again, he conquered Delhi back. Again, he came back to India. He died within a short period of time thereafter. That's why. His son Akbar became king at the age of 14 because his father died early. Humayun's son Akbar had always aspired to build a vast empire in India. He wanted to rule India. It was his dream. With this intention, he tried to persuade the mighty Rajput kings to support him. His strategy was different. He don't want to rule India opposing the Hindus or the Rajput kings. He want their support. And his strategy was different. Some among them joined hands with him. Some Rajput joined him, but Rana Pratap Simha of Mewar opposed this. Akbar put a nail. He was proud and brave warrior. Later, a fierce battle between the Rana and Akbar took place at the Haldi Ghat, Rajasthan. The war took place there. Though Rana Pratap Simha was defeated in the battle, he did not bow down to Akbar. Huge bronze statue of Rana Pratap Simha riding on his favorite horse, Chatak, and fighting in the battlefield was set up as the Haldi Ghat. After the independence, an ardent patriot, Rana Pratap is loved by all Indians. Thereafter, Akbar engaged himself actively in the military campaigns for many years. That means he took his army and went in campaigns and start conquering the all other kingdoms nearby his empire, that is Delhi. That what he conquered of that is Gujarat, Bengal, Kashmir, Kabul, and other areas, and built a vast empire. During the Akbar ruling, this was the Mughal Empire spread even towards the south also. Akbar's achievements. Administration. Akbar was an able administrator, not only a warrior. He was good administrator also, and broad-minded ruler he was. That's why he ruled India 50 years. He possessed many of the qualities needed for the great king. He was not a despotic ruler. He realized that the order to preserve his vast empire, it was necessary to win the trust of his Hindu subjects who formed the majority. He appointed Hindus to the high post in his court. He withdrew the personal tax called Hijiya, which was imposed by the earlier Muslim kings on Hindus, and also the tax levy at pilgrimage centers. So he removed the tax on the pilgrimage of Hindus, those who are traveling to the Hindu temples. They are traveling. That those are called the pilgrimage. Before, the Muslim kings used to, the Hindus should pay tax to travel to pilgrimages. But Akbar removed that. Akbar banned the slaughter of the cows and sadi practice. He even banned the slaughter of. He was supported the Hindu culture as well as the Muslim culture. That's why he ruled the India, ruled over the hearts of the India. He also opposed the child marriage. Akbar's land revenue policy was well received by the people. It was framed by his revenue minister, Raja Todarmal, was a Hindu minister. Religious policy. Akbar was tolerant of all other religions. He constructed a prayer hall, Ibadat Khana, in his new capital, Fatehpur Sikri, where he discussed the religious matters with the leaders of the various Islamic sects. Fatehpur Sikri, Fateh means it is a win over the battle. He won the battle in the for that sake, he built the Fatehpur Sikri, and he used it for religious matters, discussion of the religious matters. He invited Hindu, Jaina, Buddhist, Parsi, Christian leaders to discuss their views on the religious issues. He want to know all the religions. He want to understand the all the religions and quotes from all important religions. As a result of such discussions, he evolved a new sect called Din-e-Ilahi. It was a new religion he invented. It was a mixture of all the dharmas. He incorporated some of the best principles of different religions. All the best principles from all the religions he took, and he emerged one more religion that is called Din-e-Ilahi. However, it could attract only a handful of followers. Many followers are not there out of it. Patronage to the arts. Akbar patronized literature and art. Faizi, Abdul Fazl, and Birbal were distinguished poets in his court. The immortal singer Tansen adorned his court. Akbar's contributions to the architecture and the painting are also remarkable. Akbar's empire was spread over even to the south, the Berar. Bidar isn't captured. Ahmednagar, little bit. This was ruled by the Shahis and the south. Till this, Berar, he was ruling. Jahangir and Shahjahan, who succeeded Akbar to the throne, continued his policies to the great extent. Shahjahan achieved fame by getting the famous Taj Mahal built at Agra, the mammoth Red Fort at Delhi, and other stately palaces. Aurangzeb. Shahjahan's son, Aurangzeb, is the last well-known Mughal emperor. He ruled for a long period of 50 years. During this period, the empire expanded in all directions, but at the end declined rapidly. Religious policy. Aurangzeb was an orthodox Muslim. He stayed away from drinking wine and gambling and entertainment and music. He lived a simple life. Aurangzeb gave up the liberal policy of the Akbar. He was not liberal like Akbar. He was Pakka Muslim. He reimposed the Hijya. He again came back. Hijya means the Hindus used to pay the taxes to go to pilgrimages. He banned Hindu religious affairs, religious teachings, and celebrations. He ordered many temples to be destroyed. Among such temples were the famous Somnath Temple, Gujarat, Shiva Temple at Kashi, Uttar Pradesh, and Krishna Temple at Mathura, Uttar Pradesh. These measures created social unrest and led to rebellions. People started opposing him. The Sikh rebellions are major in this aspect. Sikhs were provoked by the Aurangzeb's religious policy. The Sikh guru, Teh Bahadur, was publicly executed in Delhi. His son, Guru Govind Singh, organized the Sikh community into the militant sect. The members were designated as a Singh. That's why all the Sikhs have a surname, Singh now. That means lion. They had to possess a 5 Ks at all time. These were Kesha, long hair, Kanga, comb, Kirpana, sword, they have sword, Kacha, a pair of knicker boxers, and Khara, a steel bracelet. This custom is prevalent among Sikhs even today. Rebellions. The Sikhs and the Rajput strongly opposed the Aurangzeb in North India. Shivaji rose in revolt in the Deccan. The revolts continued for a long time, and as a result, Aurangzeb lost enormous wealth in the battle. A large part of his army and the worst of all, his prestige he lost. Many provinces of his empire became free. The Deccan Wars sapped Aurangzeb's economic power as well as a military strength. Being exhausted, he died in the Deccan. With his death, the Mughal Empire was greatly weakened. Guru Govind Simha, Golden Temple, Amritsar. This here is the Samadhi of Guru Govind Simha. The Mughal administration. The emperor, and they possessed all civil and military powers. His judicial decision was final in all matters. The empire was divided into provinces, sabhas, districts that are sarkars, and taluks, paraganas. The Kotwal looked after law and order in the cities. Revenue system. Akbar's minister, Raja Todarmal, framed a land revenue system. What was the system? Under the system, the land revenue was fixed on the basis of the fertility of the soil. Cultural contributions. Literature. The Mughals patronized Persian literature in a special way. There were famous historians like Abul Fazl, Nizamuddin and Badoni in Akbar's court. Akbarnama is important literary work of the Abul Fazl. Dara Shukoh, the Mughal prince, was an extraordinary scholar. He translated Bhagavad Gita. Though Hindi literature did not receive royal patronage, it flourished on account of the efforts of the Bhakti saints. Ramacharitamanas, the well-known work of Tulsidas, is of this period. Architecture. Humayun's tomb in Delhi was constructed during the early period of Akbar's reign. He built a new capital near Agra and named it Fatehpur Sikri. The magnificent palaces, mosques and pavilions of this place attract tourists from all over the world. The entrance to the Jami Masjid, Buland Darwaza, here is the tallest in India. It is 40 meters tall. Humayun's tomb, Delhi. The Mughal architecture attained its glory during the reign of the Shah Jahan. Moti Mahal, the palace that he built in Agra Fort, is extremely beautiful. The Taj Mahal at the Agra shows the Mughal architecture at its best. This wonderful monument was built in memory of his queen, Mumtaz Mahal. This was Shah Jahan who got the famous Red Fort built at Delhi. Fort Agra. Red Fort, Delhi. Painting. A new school of painting known as the Chikni painting emerged during the period of the Mughals. There were more than 100 artists in Akbar's court. The art of painting reached its peak under the patronage of Jahangir. Aurangzeb, who was orthodox in outlook, did not encourage painting. Music. Music received special patronage during Akbar's reign. Large number of the musicians in his court were divided into 7 groups. Each day, a particular group gave a music recital. Tansen was the most remarkable musician of Akbar's court. Jahangir and Shah Jahan also extended patronage to music, but Aurangzeb banned music. However, music lingered in the hearts of the people. Decline of the Mughal Empire. The empire began to decline towards the end of the Aurangzeb's reign. The reasons for the decline are: the chieftains became corrupt. The intense fighting took place among the claimants to the throne. The provincial governors took advantage of the situation and declared their independence. Aurangzeb's desire to convert India into an Islamic state met with the opposition everywhere. The prolonged warfare with the Sikhs, the Rajputs and Marathas fully exhausted the resources of the empire. In the meanwhile, Nadir Shah, the Persian invader, raided Delhi. He looted the wealth amassed by the Mughals over a period of 2 centuries. He carried away the world-famous Kohinoor diamond and the peacock throne of Shah Jahan. The treasury of the Mughals became empty. Please subscribe my channel, hit the bell icon and save the playlist. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.